Yeah, so he got a DUI. I mean, what are we going to do about it?
Beto O'Rourke is here at Penn State University. He's about to speak in a few minutes. I spoke to a few students who are very excited to see him. Let's see what they had to say. Do you guys have any issues with, like, his past legal troubles as far as, like, getting a DUI?
That was unknown to us.
I don't know of a single politician who doesn't have a scandal. And so the fact that we excused Brett Kavanaugh as boys will be boys, so he got a DUI. I mean, what are we going to do about it? Like everybody has a scandal.
Honestly, I don't know a whole lot about that, but that's just probably something that I would have to look into.
I mean, I do feel strongly about issues around drunk driving. I would have questions about that.
I don't know.
I'm not familiar with them. I heard a couple stories about him, like with his writing and that. I thought it was a little off.
I think they were in the past. I think he answered for them during the Texas Senate race. And I think he acknowledges that he got through them coming from a place of privilege.
Personally, don't know much about it. But I'm sure through the campaign trail, he'll be asked those questions and he'll have to explain himself, and then I'll make my decision based off that.
I honestly don't think that that's going to be a large issue.
You have to look at it both ways, because if it was Trump that did something like that, he would be absolutely destroyed for it, but they just going to get passed. But at the same time, like, my view is you got to give people second chances. I just wish it worked both ways.
I'm personally a lot more concerned about candidates who are, like, accused of crimes, like sexual assault.
Us. They left their comfort, their language, their home, their family, everything they knew to become strangers in a strange land.
I love the guy. I think he's really young and he's got a lot of interesting ideas.
I think it's pretty cool. I did a lot of work in the midterms trying to get Democrats elected, and he was one of the Democrats that made me excited to be working for the Democratic Party.
I'm interested in, like, how he raised $6 million in 24 hours. I do want to know where that came from.
I don't personally have anything against the guy.
I think it's really exciting that he is coming to communities across the country and want to hear what people are concerned with. What our concerns are.
I think that he's a really young candidate, so he has really interesting perspectives on how to run the U.S. right now, and I feel like he could really pull a divided nation back together.
The way he talks, I feel like it's a lot of stories. He doesn't really have a stance on anything yet.
Yeah, I think it's pretty exciting. I mean, he's a big-time candidate. I think it's a good shot at getting the nomination, so.
I'm going to ask him the question that probably no one else here will ask, which is, if he wins, will he get his friend Cedric Bixler-Zavala to reunite the Mars Volta and play his inauguration?